I'm going to show you how to create a vacation or an attendance schedule for your staff. So let me show you some of the features here. So let's say you have, let's go back to January for starters. From the drop-down list, I have all the months. So there you can see in January, and I have an employee 1, 2, 3, 4 here, but you can have as many as you like. So sick days are indicated by an S. Vacation days are indicated by a V, and we have the totals there. So let's say they get 15 vacation days in a year. So you know this guy's used up 4, and he probably gets half a dozen sick days a year, and he's used up 2. So that when he wants to go look at, for example, September, then you know that he has. He's got 11 days he could use up in the next while. So let's go back to January, and then we can do it. So let me show you how I did this, and I will show you how to do it for 1 month. I did it for the whole year, and you guys are welcome to this file. It's not complete, but it's a lot of the grunt work is done. But I'll show you how I did it for 1 month so you get the idea, so you can create your own if you like. So let's start on sheet 2. And I'm going to start in B1, and I'm going to put in for the beginning of this year. So I'm going to go 01012017. Okay. I know from the fact I just did it that we need to select columns D to AH, and what we're going to do is we're going to right click on those and we're going to change the column width to 3 and say okay. And now what we're going to do is we're going to put in the dates. So what we're going to do is we're going to go equals, and then we're going to select our first date. And now that's not going to fit in there. So what we're going to do is we're going to right click on that, and we are going to go to format cells. We're going to go to number, and we're going to go to custom. So right now I have month, day, year. So I would just like to have day. So I'm going to put a D in here. And so it's just going to give me the 1, which is perfect. And now what I'm going to do is I'm going to go equals, and I'm going to select that cell, and I'm going to add 1. And so I'm going to drag this down, or this across, until I reach 31. All right. And now what we're going to do is we're going to, we can probably put boxes around this to make it look fancy. Okay, and so now what we're going to do is we are going to figure out what the weekday is, so we know which days of the week or weeks are Saturday and Sunday. So what we're going to do is we're going to go equals weekday, and we're going to do weekday of the cell below. Now, 1 is a Sunday and 7 is a Saturday. So let's just scroll right along here. And so you can see that the weekends are indicated there. So now what we're going to do is we are going to select, this is the bunch of cells below there. And what we're going to do is we are going to go conditionally format them. So on the main page, we go to conditional formatting, and we'll go new rule. And what we're going to do is we are going to use a formula to determine the rule. And so now what we're going to do is we're going to click this little red arrow here. And what we're going to do is we're going to, basing on these values, so I'm going to do it the first time. So if it equals 7, Now, big trick in this, it automatically puts conditional formatting on here. So what we're going to do is we're going to take off the dollar sign before the D and the dollar sign before the AH. If you don't do that, it won't work. And so now we'll go back to the rest of the dialog box, and we're going to click on the format button. And I like the third one down here. I'm in the fill box, and I like the third one down for the color. And I'm going to say OK. And OK again. And so now all the days that are 7, which is the Saturday, are grayed out. And I will do the exact same thing for the 1. So there you have the ones, or the Saturday and the Sundays are grayed out here. Now, in the A column is where you would put the employee names. So maybe we can put employee names here. The next two, I'm gonna want the totals for vacation and the total for sick days. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go, and then I'm going to go sick. And so what I'm going to do is I'm going to format these. I'm going to right click, and I'm going to format cells, and I'm going to go with alignment, and I'm going to go this way. Okay, and then I can make these narrower. And it really doesn't matter that you don't see the date up here. So what I can do is I'll go to that and select it, and then I'll make it white to hide it, because nobody really needs to know. So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to select this group of cells, and I'm going to say that if it's a V, then we're going to format it green. So we're going back to conditional formatting, and we're going to highlight cells and equal to, and so let's go with a V, and I want V to be green. Okay, and then we'll say okay, and then we're going to do the same thing, and we'll go for we will go for an S to be sick, and I want my sick days to be red with the dark red letters, and we're light red fill. And so we'll say okay. Now, how we're going to calculate this is we are going to use a count if. So we'll go equals count if. I really have to learn how to type. And so what we're going to do is we're going to select all the cells in here. And we're going to say count if. Let's go to the thing to make sure I'm getting it right. And then we'll say if it equals V. And we'll say OK. OK, so now to check whether it's working, let's put a V in here. And let's put a V in there. Okay, and let's do the exactly same thing for sick days as well. So now let me try to see whether these sick days work out. And so we'll put a sick day in here. And a sick day in here. And so there are the totals. Now, to bring it down, all you need to do is just drag it down. Grab the fill handle and drag it down. Whoop. So there you go. So now, how I divided my months on the where I had the year is what I did is I selected the entire month, the B column to the AH column, and then what I went is to the name box, and I named this January. So there I'm going back to the other sheet. So what I named each one of these is I selected them the columns, and then I called them January. So that way, if you wanted to go to March, you, just a matter of what the name box brings you there. So that's how I made a attendance or vacation scheduler. Like I say, you can email me and I will send you the file that I have done so far. You're welcome to it. But it's pretty easy to do. Please subscribe. Thank you.